Hi guys, in this video, we will discuss Burp Intercept Proxy and how to use it efficiently in the process of network traffic inspection. Because of its many features, it is usually preferred for web applications pen test. In our exercises, we'll use its proxy features mostly. We're going to work with the community edition, which has all the features we need. Let's start a new project and wait for it to finish. There. Before diving in, let's quickly mention some of its features. Proxy, we will see in a bit. Intruder is very useful for web application pen test and automated analysis, for example, sending different payloads, different positions in the request, and so on. Repeater is also very useful to discover vulnerabilities in web applications because you can fine-tune and tweak the requests. Sequencer is very similar with Intruder in purpose. Then we have various decoders, URL, HTML, Base64, binary, and so on. Let's also briefly mention Comparer, which allows us to compare two requests or two responses and find out the differences between them. For the purpose of our exercise, we'll focus on the proxy feature. As any other proxy, Burp will interpose itself between our application and the web server, allowing us to intercept and modify the request and response. We will simulate the server using FakeNet, as we've done before. Remember, guys? We start the FakeNet application, okay. In the proxy options tab, we see that it is listening on the 8080 port on localhost. Let's open the browser to verify that FakeNet is started, okay. Let's see what happens if we open a random website. We get the FakeNet default page, but nothing in Burp Intercept. The reason is because we need to configure proxy settings. So we go to Internet Options, Connections, LAN Settings, and enable the proxy on port 8080 and make sure it's enabled for all the protocols. Okay, guys. If we return to the browser and refresh the page, notice we have the request intercepted here. It is a GET request. We have the headers, we have access to the raw data. We will forward this request and we don't care about the other ones because they are aimed for the Windows Update server. So we disable the intercept and notice in the history, very, very useful, we have the request, the response, various ways to interpret them, hex HTML, render page, and so on. Okay, but what happens if we work with an application that doesn't support the proxy option, like Internet Explorer? We need a way to somehow make the application proxy aware. Let's clear the history first. For this, we will use this small tool called Proxifier. It allows us to define new proxy servers and new rules for other third-party applications. In our case, let's add Burp as a proxy, address 127.0.0.1 and port 8080. For the protocol, we can choose between HTTP and HTTPS. Let's stick with HTTPS and we'll see why in a bit. If we go to advanced, we can add a custom label, Burp, okay. Then check the connectivity. All right, connection established. Cool. Okay. Do we want to add this as a default? Yes, sure. Okay. Notice in the history the request coming from Proxifier. This is the test request. Okay, so we added the proxy. Now we need to add a rule. In our case, the application that we're trying to test is this malware sample here. If we double click and execute it, we don't have anything in burp, no request here. We can see an error here, but no request. So we need to make the application proxy aware. Let's continue with creating a new rule. We click add, then select the sample. We want the sample to go through burp, okay? And by default, we will use the action direct, so not through the proxy. All right. Okay. Before continuing, we have to also make sure that we disabled the proxy, which is set system-wise, because otherwise burp would give an error. Okay, we disable the proxy. We don't need Internet Explorer anymore. Okay, let's double check that everything is in place. We have the proxy server. We have a proxy rule, so our sample should go through burp proxy. Okay, let's go to burp and enable intercept. Click intercept is on and then start the sample. Okay, notice we got a request here for Adobe update.info, which will let us through, and we have the FakeNet default executable program being run. This is a sign that our sample requested a binary file and executed that. Okay. If we go to HTTP history tab, notice that strangely there is no request here, although we've seen the request before. What happens is that by default, burp has some filters. Notice here, filter. In our case, it says hiding image and general binary content. To quickly view our request, let's enable everything with show all, and we can notice now our request. The request went to a host name which was resolved by FakeNet. We can see if we scroll, DNS server was resolved here, and there was a request for an executable, for which again FakeNet had a reply, and it replied with FakeNet mini.exe binary that we've seen running. If we look in the response, we can notice the MZ header followed by the actual FakeNet mini binary. So guys, to recap, in this video, we've seen that it is actually possible for any Windows application to be proxified, and we can send the traffic to burp or a different other tool for analysis. In our case, we used the Proxifier tool, we created a new proxy server which pointed to burp, and we created a new rule for our sample to also go through burp. In the next practice, we'll discuss about a slightly different tool and we'll see some of its advantages. Thank you. Cheers.